video, let us look at very important features about gross specimens. Okay, we are not going into the fancy features, the size of the specimen, the color of the specimen, not those things, but very specific things we will look at. Okay, this is acute appendicitis. So you will say appendix is swollen, there is fibrinopurulent exudate, mucosa is ulcerated, sloughed off, the serosa will be hyperemic, right? So what will you see in the microscopy if they ask? You will see a lot of neutrophils. So these are very classic things that we are telling you, right? Because it is an infection, so you will see neutrophilic infiltration, purulent exudate, right? So all these things you will say, mucosa is ulcerated, sloughed off, serosa is hyperemic, appendix itself is swollen, and there could be fecal lith, etc. Osteoclastoma, giant cell tumor, what will you see? It will usually affect the epiphysis of the long bone. Here you will see well circumscribed, dark tan kind of appearance, right? There is a thin shell of periosteal bone, hemorrhagic, necrotic, honeycombed appearance you can see. What will you see in the microscopy? You will see lot of giant cells which are osteoclast-like with 100 nuclei, etc. And then the stromal cells which are actual tumor cells, they will be spindle-shaped, etc. Breast fibroadenoma, so it is most common benign tumor of this. Then it usually affects people of reproductive life. So in this, what will you see? Small, solitary, well-encapsulated discoid mask. Remember, discoid mask, you will see encapsulated discoid mask. When you cut it, you will see firm gray-white myxoid slit-like spaces. You should see slit-like spaces. Okay. Microscopy, you will see intracanalicular pattern, pericanalicular pattern. Then let's move to the next specimen, carcinoma breast here. So carcinoma breast, what are the very specific things you will write here? Hard, cartilage-like mass, tumor is irregular. Then when you cut it, it will be cutting with grating sound. Obviously, it's hard, cartilage-like, right? Then you will see chalky streaks, chalky streaks you will see. Then in the microscopy, what have you seen? Comedonecrosis, tumor cells in nests. Look at this, adenocarcinoma colon. Basically, it looks like it's on the right side. So there is a fungating large cauliflower-like soft friable mass projecting into the lumen. Okay, if it's on the left side, it will be napkin ring configuration. If it was on the left side, you should have written that, right? In this, what will you see in the microscopy? Infiltrating glands into the muscularis. Malignant glands will be there, okay? So chronic cholecystitis, the gallbladder wall is thick. The gallbladder will contract, right? This is a chronic condition, so it would have contracted. There is fibrosis of the wall. The cut section will be gray-white. You will see mucosal folds are thickened, atrophied, flattened. You can, in this specimen, you are able to see black stones, right? So this could be bile stones, which are mulberry-shaped. Multiple stones will be there, right? Then, what will you see otherwise? You will see in the microscopy, you will see Rokit-Ansky-Ashoff sinus, chronic inflammatory cells, right, fibrosis. You can see stones also. If you cut the stones, you will see soft black stones because it is, here you are able to see that. Specimen of gallstones, you will have pure cholesterol, pure pigment stones. Then what you will have, pure calcium stones. You can have mixed stones, combined stones. So many options are there. Then let us look at atheromatous plaque of heart. So, atheromatous plaque of heart, you should tell the gross morphology means how you will say white to yellowish lesion, white to yellowish lesion. It's not very clear in this, right? Somewhere where they have pinned it, atheromatous plaque, white to yellowish white lesion, 1 to 2 centimeters, raised surface. That's all. Microscopy, what will be there in atheromatous plaque? Fibrous cap, cellular area, deeper central soft core with cholesterol clefts and all that, right? Moving on. Hydronephrosis of kidney. You can see dilated spaces here. Calluses, pelvis, thin cortex, right? Here they are saying the ureter has some issue. Ureter transitional cell carcinoma of ureter is there here. So there is like papillary type of free floating fern like arrangement. Right? Friable mass here in the ureter. So how will you grade this in microscopy? Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, MOST FQI, that seems to be the spelling, MOST FQI, MOST Q. I'm not sure of the pronunciation, grades. Renal cell carcinoma, solitary unilateral tumor, upper pole of kidney. So you can see here, if this is kidney, you have it in the upper pole, solitary unilateral tumor, only on one side. It can be papillary, you will see here. Then the cross section, you will see cystic change, necrosis, hemorrhage, ischemic necrosis, hemorrhage. That is here, right? You can see hemorrhage. Then the renal vein can be involved, tumor thrombosis. In the microscopy, what and all types will be there in renal cell carcinoma? In renal cell carcinoma, there will be a clear cell type, papillary type, chromophobe type, sacromatoid type, granular, collecting duct type. So many types are there in renal cell carcinoma. Look at the lipoma. Lipoma, soft tissue, yellow, well encapsulated, soft, homogeneous, greasy. In the microscopy, you will see adipocytes with fibrovascular septa. Next, chronic venous congestion of liver, CVC liver. You should be able to see nutmeg appearance, right? Congested zone 3, fatty peripheral zones. The capsule will be tense, okay? Because this is CVC liver, so a lot of congestion will be there. So the capsule will become tense. The liver will be enlarged, tender. In microscopy, you will see that zone 3 is having hemorrhagic necrosis, centrilobular hemorrhagic necrosis. Zone 1 will have peripheral fatty change. Look at nutmeg liver, same thing. CVC liver, you can see this is also nutmeg liver, CVC liver. Now let's look at cirrhosis liver, the gross specimen. You can see in cirrhosis liver, you can see large liver, fatty. The nodules are less than 3 millimeter in diameter, so it's micronodular. The surface will have hobnail liver, it is called as nodules with fibrous septa. This is what cirrhosis of liver. Microscopically, you will see same thing. Loss of normal hepatocellular architecture. You cannot spot the central vein. There will be necrosis, fatty change, micronodules, ductal proliferation. Fatty liver, again, enlarged liver, yellow, greasy, smooth, firm, glistening capsule, because obviously it's full of fat, right? Take a break, guys. How's it going? We're looking at what now? Fatty liver, okay? Gross features. And some microscopy also we're talking about. So basically in microscopy, you will see microvesicular droplets, macrovesicular droplets, lipogranuloma, etc. Hepatocellular carcinoma, in gross you will have expanding type, multifocal, infiltrating types, and in microscopy you will see, what will you see in microscopy? Trabecular sinusoidal pattern, pseudoglandular acinar pattern, compact pattern, cirrus pattern. Anyways, in the most common pattern, that is trabecular or sinusoidal pattern, you will see trabeculae, cells which are therein, like 2 to 8 cells, trabecular sinusoidal pattern, okay, in nodules. Look at this specimen. It is a metastatic lung deposit or secondary deposit, you can say. So basically, in blood-borne metastasis, usually it happens, but it is possible in other ways also. Okay, basically carcinoma of bowel, breast, thyroid, kidney, pancreas, lung, they all can somehow land up with deposits in the lung. So most common in the peripheral part of the lung, okay, metastases are most common in the peripheral part of the lung, okay, and there will be discrete nodular lesions. So it will look like cannon ball secondaries. So there is some word here, cannon ball secondaries, okay. This looks like a lymph node specimen, right? Yes, so it's a tuberculous lymph node, actually. Matted appearance, matted together lymph node. In cross-section, you'll see map-like areas, dry cheese, soft necrotic material resembling dry cheese. In microscopy, you will see granuloma. So matted together, these words should come out. They ask you TB lymph node, matted together, map-like, dry cheese, all that, okay? Moving on to dermoid cyst. So basically dermoid cyst, mature benign teratoma, germ cell tumor. It could be ovary actually. It's a unilocular cyst, skin, sebaceous secretions, hair, rocket and ski protuberance, tooth, bone, cartilage, whatnot on earth, everything can be there in this. Microscopy, you will have to mention stratified squamous epithelium and everything else that we just mentioned, you should be able to see all that in the microscopy. Shall we move on? Mucinous cyst adenocarcinoma. So this is a carcinoma. So here you will see it is an epithelial tumor, ovary it is. It is going to be larger than the serous type. Smooth surface cysts with characteristic multiloculation containing thick viscous viscid gelatinous fluid. Okay. So the malignant variety has thick septa. This is malignant variety because this is carcinoma, it says. It should have thick septa. Moving on. Carcinoma penis, so you can see cauliflower like appearance. So definitely this is squamous cell carcinoma. Friable growth, gray white, fungating, cauliflower like. And in the microscopy, what will you see in squamous cell carcinoma, guys? You will see keratin pearls. Same squamous cell carcinoma, but here the specimen is of some skin. Okay, skin you can see here. So you can't say it's penis, but squamous cell carcinoma. Okay. So let's look at CVC spleen now. So CVC spleen, what will you see in gross? Enlarged, congested, tense capsule, right? That's what you can say here, tense. It says just tense, so we'll go with tense, cyanotic. And when you cut it, you will see gray tan appearance. Don't forget that, gray tan appearance. It should be cyanotic, right? In microscopy, what will you see? Congested sinusoids, gamma antibodies, capillarization of sinusoids, red pulp hyperplasia, right? The capsule and the trabeculae are also tense. Splenic infarct, you can see that there will be occlusion of the splenic artery or its branches. There can be thromboemboli. So basically, what will you see here? Wedge-shaped. Mainly, you can see here pale, anemic, wedge-shaped, you can see here. So this wedge, usually this infarct will have a base at the periphery and apex pointing towards the hilum. Microscopy, what will you see? Necrosis, inflammatory reaction, fibrous scar, etc. Nothing specific here in the microscopy. Let's move on to carcinoma stomach. So basically stomach carcinoma, what will you see? Flat infiltrating ulcerative growth, irregular necrotic base, raised margin. Let's move on. Gastric ulcer. So looks like here the ulcer is actually here. Okay, this could be a healed ulcer, that's what they said. So basically gastric ulcer is usually more common in the lesser curvature, right? Pyloric antrum, first part of duodenum, all those peptic ulcers can be there. Now we are talking about the gastric ulcer here, so the stomach. So what will you see? Small round oval, round to oval, punched out lesions. Mucosal folds, they converge towards the ulcer. You can see superficial exudative zone, necrotic zone in the microscopy. Exudative zone, necrotic zone, then so many zones are there, right? Necrotic zone, exudate zone, granulation tissue, zone of cicatrization. Okay. Moving on. Multinodular goiter. So, multinodular goiter, you will see asymmetric enlargement of the thyroid. Nodularity will be there. Poor encapsulation, fibrous scarring, hemorrhage, focal calcification, cystic degeneration, variegated appearance basically. So, here you will see what and all large follicles. The epithelium usually will be inactive, right? And they'll be full of colloid, correct? Multinodular goiter, you have seen the microscopy already. Papillary carcinoma of thyroid. So basically here you can see that there is fibrosis, calcification. Cut surface will show grayish white, hard, scar like. Papillary cyst adenocarcinoma. What is this? Yes, same thing. So basically in microscopy you will see papillary structure, orphan annei, right? Clear ground glass appearance, sarcoma bodies, intranuclear inclusions, so many things you will see. Intramural lioma. So basically this is also called wandering fibroid or something. So here you will have nodular circumscribed gray-white. Here you can see nodular circumscribed gray-white. It's intramural leiomyoma. Otherwise you have subserosal, submucosal also varieties. They can have pedicle, they can be pedunculated, but not this intramural one, okay? Then in microscopy, you will see whorl-like pattern of the benign smooth muscle cells. So we have seen a lot of gross specimens in this video. Hope you have learned something from this video. This is very, very basic or very specific points about these, okay?